Welcome back to Let's Play Star Trek 25th Anniversary Blind. I'm the RPG chick. I do have a slight cold.
Loves Labor Jeopardized.
Trying to get over with, so bear with me. I can pause there. I want to say an R.I.P. rest in peace to Anton Yelchin, if I'm pronouncing that correctly, who played Chekhov in the Star Trek reboot series, of course. He literally died. Well, I'm recording this on the 20th, and it's going to be put up on the 20th, so if you're watching this the day it came out, he died yesterday. Actually, it was the 19th he died. Some kind of freak accident where he was crushed between a security gate and a car. I'm not sure. Adam may not have not seen the latest, or we may have not have heard the latest. But in any case, a tragedy to be sure. He also played parts in I forget. A few other shows. You know, movies. What was it, To Kiss a Spider? I'm not sure. He played the kid in that. The one with, well, Morgan Freeman plays, Morgan Freeman plays Alex Cross, and he has a bunch of movies that I haven't seen, but I really enjoyed his, portrayal of Chekhov in the series. He's one of the characters that I really liked. Took me a long time to get used to the new Kirk, the new Spock. So I really enjoyed Chekhov a lot, as well as Scotty, the new Scotty. But yeah. Anyway, onward. I normally don't even, you know, say this kind of stuff during my Let's Plays, but I'm playing a Star Trek game, and Chekhov's there in the seat. I know it's not the same Chekhov, but still. Regardless. Anyway, continuing.
Priority message from Starfleet.
On screen, Lieutenant.
A raid across the Romulan neutral zone has placed Starfleet Research Station Arc 7 in jeopardy. Proceed immediately to Arc 7 and determine the status of the station. Good luck, Jim.
Okay, Arc 7. Where the hell's Arc 7? I gotta check my little map here. So I'm gonna be muting the mic from time to time to cough, sniffle, stuff like that. You guys wonder what the noise is. Where's this Arc 7? Arc 7 is at 3. Wow, yeah. Okay, so we're all the way up. Tactical map is... I know it's not M. Like, you think it would be... Map would be M. It's actually not tactical map, but navigational map. N. So that would be... That's 2... That's 1, that's 3, is Arc 7. Engage! Oop, wrong Star Trek show. My voice is horrible.
We have arrived at Arc 7. Romulan ship decloaking, Captain.
Uh-oh.
Message from the Romulan ship, sir.
Treachery! We are aware of Federation plans. Prepare to die.
They're arming weapons, Captain.
Arming weapons.
He'll put shields up first. Alright, where are they? All the way down here. Prepare to die, Romulan scum. Cloaking, I can see you though. Not really. I really can't see crap. They'll show up on the map either. We gotta wait till they appear. I know they have to appear to attack. Whoa! I'm not sure why. Oh, I saw them too. You can see them because they blot out the stars, but it's really hard if you have no idea where they are. I apologize for my voice being completely terrible. I don't know why he would decloak when he's not really near us. Analysis?
Target analysis. Odd. Target analysis. Odd.
Apparently undamaged at this point. This could be a lengthy battle. Hello, hello, hello! Oh, I saw you. He was headed that way. I can't see him. Maybe if I went to full screen, I could. Hold on, what's the full screen again? I forgot. V for view. I don't want him killing me while I try to look up my commands here. I see you. I see you. I think this battle's about over. Okay, now I don't know where they are. That worked. That really worked. That was a good idea. Thanks, me. Problem, me.
Target analysis on.
Okay, he's a little damaged. The enemies are getting
target
tougher.
Target analysis off.
Gotta say, I can see that. The Elassi were a pushover. They didn't hurt us at all. Actually, neither are these guys. Where are they? They're not appearing.
Target analysis off.
They're healing their... Aw, crap. They're repairing their ship. Can I even find them like this? Oh! They're going this way? I don't know where the hell they are. What? Come on, come on, come on. Keep up.
They activated a self-destruct device rather than be captured, Captain.
Oh my god.
New course to Arc 7, Captain.
Sheesh. Self-destruct device. Oh, is this a space station? Right, right, that's what they were saying.
Captain, there is an auto-beacon broadcasting from the station.
Warning. Warning. As per UFB Regulation 342-1885-64.3, paragraph 3, this base is currently under a Class 3 biohazard alert. All personnel are ordered to stay away from this base unless they are part of a biohazard response team.
Well, we aren't. Can't analyze the station, can I?
Target analysis on.
No.
Target analysis on.
Mr. Spock?
Captain, sensors indicate a breathable atmosphere in the space station. It seems that whatever ARC-7's intentions, it managed to create a biohazard that is deadly to Romulans. 17 humans and 10 Romulans are on the station. The humans are all in perfect health. So it seems we can beam over without any fear of contamination.
Alright. Sounds like a good idea. Peter. Arc 7.
Arc 7. A highly sophisticated arcology project looking into the origins of life in the universe. The project is being led by Dr. Carol Marcus, who, along with a crew of 17 members, is dedicated to unlocking the mystery of life. Further information is classified.
Tell me anything about Marcus?
Marcus. Carol. The current chief of research on Station Arc 7. Carol Marcus is an expert in molecular biology, bioprotein development, cell mutation science, and radiation science. Dr. Marcus has been offered many posts in the Federation, but refuses to be involved in any project which may have a direct military application.
Very talented. Did I look up Romulans before? I think I might have just looked up Klingons.
Romulans. A race descended from Vulcan stock, but one that did not reject aggression as the Vulcans did. On a sensor, the two races appear very similar. Their individuals are known for being more passionate and emotional than their Vulcan counterparts. They currently use ships of Klingon design, suggesting to some the Klingons are maintaining them as a client state to antagonize the Federation in a move that circumvents the Organian peace treaty.
Who are these Organians I've been hearing about?
Organian treaty.
It's a treaty.
A peace treaty between Klingons and the Federation, inspired by the Organians. The Organians have enough power to stop all starships everywhere, so the peace will be maintained de facto, whether anyone wants it or not.
I mean, apparently they're a thing, but I just don't remember Organians. I want to hear about the race, though, not necessarily the treaties, so although that was good, too.
Organians. A race of transhumanoid beings that can manifest themselves in many forms. The Organians are a race of extraordinary power and wisdom. Organian intervention in the Klingon Federation War resulted in the Organian Peace Treaty, which settles border disputes between the two cultures.
Oh, I was going to advance that down. Okay. I sense that the... Okay, hold on one second, guys. I sense that the music may be overpowering the dialogue, which is not good. Okay. Hopefully, I've put the music down by 5 and the, you know, the rest of the game up by 5. So hopefully that fixes things. Thinking anything else to look up on the computer? Q.
Topic not available, Captain.
Maybe that's a little better. The voices, anyway. Anyway, so let's go beam down.
Captain, the shields are up.
Can we just automatically bring down the shields?
Lowering shields, Captain.
Spock, come with me. Mr. Scott, you have the car.
Wonder what red shirt we're gonna have with us this time.
You are on the bridge of the Ark 7.
As well I expected I would be.
James Kirk watches the Romulan ship with concern.
Actually, he's facing away from the ship.
McCoy is fidgeting around.
He's done that before.
Spock is analyzing the surroundings.
And Spock's done that before.
Lieutenant Ferris watches the exits carefully.
Save Ferris!
A Romulan bird of prey hovers menacingly on the view screen.
So there's more than one. Is he docked here? Why could we not see this before? Where is this view screen aimed at?
You are on the bridge of the... You are on the bridge of the...
I want to look at these monitors.
You are on the bridge of the...
I'm on the bridge of the...
You are on the bridge of the Ark 7. This is a heavily secured door leading to another section of the station. Its access code has been breached.
Now, I'm also wondering about the length of this episode, because the first one took me about an hour and a half to finish, and the second episode half that time. So, I was not expecting to be done, and, well, it took me over an hour, but once I edited out all my messing around, actually it took me an hour and 2 minutes, but I edited a lot out of me just getting to fruitless, repeated, you know, outcomes.
You are on the bridge of the... You are on the bridge of the Ark. You are on the bridge of the Ark.
All this interesting stuff, I can't look at it.
You are on the bridge of...
Excuse me, guys. Hold on a second.
You are on the bridge. You are on the bridge of the
Ark. My.
This is a standard door leading to another room on this deck.
Standard door leading to another standard room. What about all this equipment?
This computer terminal is linked into the station's main computer. It is currently running an open file of log programs.
I can't stand the way my voice sounds, guys, but, sheesh. If I don't record now, we'll have no episode for today.
This computer terminal...
Alright, this is all one terminal?
This computer
Alright.
Strange that the bridge is empty. Stay sharp, everyone. The station's computer system might give us some answers.
So when you talk to Kirk, it's not really that you're talking to Kirk. Kirk's talking to everyone.
Nice view of the Romulan ship. How comforting. Nothing unusual here, Captain. Though the station's computer may be able to tell us something.
I expect that it might.
This is a very dangerous situation, sir. We should proceed with caution.
Yes, of course you would say that. You're the red shirt. Spock, analyze stuff.
Nothing to report, Captain. Nothing unusual is detected. Nothing to report, Captain. Nothing to report, Captain. The main computer banks of the Ark 7. It looks like someone has recently been rummaging through the main databanks.
Mm-hmm. I wonder who that could be. Romulans or someone? Well, other than leave the room.
Spock, check out the station's computer and see what you can dig up.
You said it switched, Spock.
Dr. Marcus Long. Supplemental. Continued testing of the Ouroboros virus confirms its potential harmful effects on Romulan Vulcan humanoids. As soon as the spill has been cleaned up, we will sterilize both labs and purge the circulation system to make sure no traces of the virus will remain viable. Then all research files must be erased. We must leave no chance that this terrible accident will ever be repeated.
Doctor, you may be interested in the medical data file appended to the log.
Spock, check out the station's computer and see what you can dig up.
Look at Spock,
Dr.
go away.
Marcus Long. Supplemental.
Ouroboros
continued
virus?
Testing of the Ouroboros virus confirms its potential harmful effects on Romulan Vulcan humanoids. As soon as the spill has been cleaned up, we will sterilize both labs and purge the circulation system to make sure...
Doctor, you may be interested.
Alright. Bones has been formally invited to check out the logs.
There's nothing there requiring a ship's doctor.
I guess I switch to him. Go to work, man.
Now that's interesting. There's more here. All of Dr. Marcus' research data on the Ouroboros virus. Let me see. Virus growth patterns. Pneumonococcal mimic affecting Romulan Vulcan genotype. Alveoli involvement in... Boy, Jim, this bug works fast.
Is this really the time to catch up on your reading, Doctor?
Now listen here, you pointy-eared...
Gentlemen, I think we have more pressing problems.
Jim, there is an appended medical database online. Also, it would be useful for me to experiment on how the virus grows in the presence of different gases.
Virus?
I'm sure the station has the necessary equipment.
That's highly illogical of you, Spock. You invite him over there to look at the logs and then chastise him when he does so. What the hell? Anything else to say?
Nice view of the Romulan.
Nothing new in light of... findings.
Nothing unusual here.
Okay, so what's the test of virus, but we don't have time to do that now. Well, we got two doors. This is a standard door. This one's been compromised. Check out this. Okay, interesting. Freezer unit. Kind of hydraulic. Something else. Spock's coughing. What's going on, Spock?
This is a very well-equipped laboratory, Captain. Perhaps Dr. McCoy could be of some use here.
He's not coming down with the virus, is he?
You get no response.
This level appears deserted, sir, but I'm worried about a Romulan counterattack. They outnumber us.
Mm-hmm.
When you're finished admiring all the equipment, Bones, maybe you can help us figure out what's going on here.
I'm worried that he's catching the virus, so...
Jim, this lab is incredible. What I wouldn't give to have some of this equipment on the Enterprise.
I mean, it was probably too late. Can I have him leave the room?
He looks at you with a puzzled expression.
I don't mean him.
Mr. Spock is thinking about chemical formulas. This is a research lab with lots of expensive equipment.
Yeah, no kidding.
James Tiberius Kirk.
That he is.
Dr. McCoy is thinking about chemical formulas.
McCoy?
Mr. Spock is thinking about...
K- chemical formulas.
Ensign Ferris doesn't know much about chemical formulas.
She says in the exact same cadence, too. That's so funny. Look at everything else.
This is a research lab. This is a distillator used to isolate specific compounds from raw material.
Or distill them?
This is a distillator used to This is a distillator you.
Okay, she's very... Oh, we got a ladder down, I just noticed that.
A device to accelerate neutrinos. Not much good for anything else.
Well, if we need to accelerate any neutrinos, it's right there for us.
This is a research... This device is used for the rapid reproduction of virus cultures in the presence of suspected anti-agents.
Hmm.
This is a large engineering safety door with heavy shielding. Its entry codes seem to be breached. This is a large refrigeration unit.
Never would have guessed that one.
This is a standard door. This is an access ladder. It appears to lead to the next deck below.
Okay. We've already got a bunch of rooms that appear to be open to us, so this might be a longer episode. Can we work this equipment? Did I look at this little podium thing here?
This is a res...
Let's see.
It is a standard research lab. A Krygelian tube basic compound distillator. Excellent piece of equipment for reducing complex materials to their basic compounds. A Hawking neutrino accelerator. It is one of the finest in production today.
Named after Stephen Hawking?
I fail to see the logic in that action, Captain.
Analyze everything, Spock. Oh, he opened it. Interesting.
This refrigerator has a number of specimen dishes inside.
I'm sick too, Spock. It's alright.
Nothing to report, Captain.
Hmm.
Residue of a viral agent is still within the chamber.
Got. Oh, he just closed it. Oh, I thought he took something. Alright. Can I get something?
You take the Ouroboros virus culture.
You know, they've spelled it both ways. O-U-S and U-S. I have little notes here, and I thought I spelled it wrong. I crossed it out and put O-U-S, and now they're spelling it with U-S again. Let's look at the thing, which is achieved by going that and that.
There are many virus culture dishes, all of them labeled Ouroboros virus. Danger.
Danger, Will Robinson. We analyzed that, Mr. Spock. Oh, wait.
The seals on these dishes are intact. But that's all I can determine.
Okay.
The nozzle is empty.
Well, there's a nozzle. Huh.
There is nothing at the moment for me to do there. There is nothing at the moment for me to do there.
Okay. I'm supposed to put that there?
That nozzle is for anti-agents only, Jim.
We're the anti-agents. Wait. Can I get something else from here?
You take the Ouroboros virus culture.
I already have the Ouroboros virus culture. Okay. Can I get anything else? Can I get something here?
The nozzle is empty. You fail to obtain anything. You fail to obtain anything.
Well, there's more rooms to go in. Back in the other room, there was a room headed this way, so I can only assume that goes there. Mm-hmm.
This is a science lab.
Thank you.
This is a synthesizer used to combine and replicate chemicals and form new compounds. This particular model has twin gas feeds.
Okay.
This is a synthesizer used to combine and replicate chemicals and form new compounds. An RDAC 1000. The last word in molecular replication, one of the most advanced pieces of scientific equipment ever constructed.
It would take us several hours to get this machine working, Captain. I do not believe we will need it. The synthesis chamber should be able to give us what we need.
Okay.
A gas tank marked O2. A gas tank marked H2. This is a science lab. This is a synthesizer. This is a synthesizer.
They're all synthesizers. So we're not going to need anything in here then? Can we get this stuff?
You fail to obtain anything.
Nope.
It's what I was afraid of, Jim. I think Spock is getting worse.
Yeah. He is getting sick, right?
Spock is analyzing the surroundings. McCoy is fidgeting around. James Tiberius. Lieutenant Ferris is carefully watching the hallway.
So we don't need to go in here?
The can looks much too heavy to carry, sir.
I thought it does. I guess we won't need anything in here, then. Can we analyze anything?
Nothing to report, Captain. Nothing to report, Captain. Nothing to report, Captain. Nothing unusual is detected. Nothing to report.
All right, we're out of here. We might be on some kind of time limit, in which case Spock is doomed because... Now, I'm guessing this also goes here? Right. Okay. Can we go through this? We can.
It's a standard adjustable metric socket wrench.
Take.
You pick up a large wrench.
I sure do.
This is the engineering center for the Ark 7 space station. Turbines of a Cochrane 500 class fusion drive, manufactured over a century ago on Alpha Centauri.
I didn't realize that they use these old fusion reactors anymore.
Actually, Doctor, as Mr. Scott would tell you, the Cochrane 500 is renowned for its reliability and perfectly suited for a station of this size.
Hey, this thing's real old, isn't it?
My.
Lieutenant Ferris is carefully... McCoy is...
There's nothing new with this stuff.
Spock is analyzing... Kirk is looking closely at the equipment.
I don't think I talked to them in the other room, though.
At least all this equipment appears to be operating.
Captain, the fusion reactor doesn't seem to have been tampered with. I suggest we leave the controls as they are.
Sir, I'll watch the door so we don't get cornered.
Thank you, Bueller. Ferris.
The station's fusion reactor. Very nice. What are we going to tour next? The ventilation system?
Actually, might be a good idea. That might be how the virus is spreading around. Looking at more stuff.
This is the engineering center. This is the engineering...
So there's nothing really to look at here.
This is the engineering...
Nothing unusual is detected. Nothing unusual. The fusion reactor is functioning at peak efficiency. There is no need to tamper with its current operation.
Fusion reactor? Is this where it came through? What is this?
This is a service access panel permitting used up or worn materials to be replaced. This is a service access...
Can I open that?
The panel opens. You see a gas tank labeled N2 with its feed lines running deeper into the wall.
Okay, so we've got an N2 tank here.
N2 gas tank.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing to report, Captain.
Can't do anything with this? We can't take it, right?
The tank is large and heavy with its feed lines firmly attached. The tank is large and heavy with it.
All right. All right. This isn't anything, right? Here?
This is the engineering.
All right, let's go. Still can go downstairs. Can't we?
Watch out, sir. It looks like the Romulans have taken control of the lower decks.